Good morning, students. So for your seventh semester, the next course is Microwave Engineering. As I told you, all the courses which I teach are related. So what we first studied was Electromagnetic Engineering. Next we studied Antenna and Radio Wave Propagation. Now we are studying Microwave Engineering. You might say why this R comes into picture. R stands for radar. In the old syllabus, we had a subject microwave and radar engineering. Now radar is removed, but still we use the same short form MRE. So next, finally, we will study it in 8th semester, RF designs. This you studied in which semester? 5th semester. So this was for 6th, 7th and 8th. So if you see, there is a trend here. First, you studied mainly Maxwell's equations over here. Then you went one step further from Maxwell's equations, you designed antennas. Now we are going one step further. What we are going using Maxwell's equations, we'll be studying various components. So what are the components, we'll see one by one. And finally, we'll be going to design of this component. So this comes finally. So that is what you do in final year. You study about various components and finally you try to design those components. Then only you will be called engineers when you are able to design your own components. So what we will be studying MRE is, first we will study about the introduction to the subject. So in introduction, what will we study? What was the last module of EE? It was related to transmission lines. So it introduced us to something called a Smith chart. So what you have studied in BEE, you have studied maximum power transfer theorem. Now when is maximum power transferred? When RTH equal to RL. But now when we come to AC sources, resistance becomes impedance. So ZL should be equal to ZD. Right? So maximum power transfer theorem becomes this. Right? So maximum power is transferred only when the impedance, ZL equal to ZD. ZL equal to Z0, where Z0 is characteristic impedance of the transmission line. So ZL should be equal to Z0 always. Then only maximum power will be transferred. So this is called as, so usually this is not the case when we design directly. ZL is not equal to Z0. So the process of making ZL equal to Z0 using some networks is called as impedance matching. So we'll study mainly impedance matching in this module. Now you might say, why is it called as introduction then? Because at the start we have something called as advantages of microwave, applications of microwaves. Those are all trivial topics. Those you can do yourself. Then we have something called as strip lines and microstrip lines. So what are strip lines and microstrip lines? Everyone uses smartphones. So there are very small circuits in there. So these circuits, you might see golden lines going here and there. They might be orbit going like this. So these are called as strip lines or microstrip lines. So what is this? We'll see in detail later. So I'll cover this, even though this is from first module, we'll see this later. I'll first start with impedance matching. And this impedance matching we have to do using Smith chart. So we have already introduced Smith chart in EE. The topic was transmission lines. So in this lecture, we'll study the basics of Smith chart. So it will be a very short lecture. So this is the first module which we'll study. So what is the second module? Second module is waveguides. So what are waveguides? So if you observe strip lines and microstrip lines, as I told you, they are usually used in mobiles and other very small components. They are of the range of micrometer, nanometer. So they are very small, right? But waveguides are very huge. Then you might say, sir, then why we use waveguides? Because they are almost lossless. We have very less loss if it is designed properly, right? So this is the advantage. And they are usually used in satellite communications as an example. So even though they are bulky, they are used in satellites because they have very low loss. So waveguides we'll study. So we'll mainly study rectangular waveguides and circular waveguides. And there is something very interesting concept called as modes. Don't know, you might have heard about something called as TEM mode, TE mode, TM mode, then TE11, TE01, TE10 or TM01. All these type of modes we'll study in this module. We'll not study TEM because it is a coaxial cable mode. So you have only rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. So that won't come yet. But we'll have an introduction to that mode. This is second module. Third module is microwave tubes. So we study various microwave tubes like klystron, magnetron, if you have heard about it, backward wave oscillator, traveling wave tube. So what are these things? These come under the aegis of something called as HPM. It stands for high power microwave. So what are high power microwaves? These tubes deliver very high amount of power. It is in the range of gigawatts or megawatts. And what is the peculiarity of this? They generate this huge amount of power in a very short duration of nanoseconds. So that's why this field is called as high power microwaves. So these tubes use this. Now if you have magnetron, if you have heard about it, it is used in microwave ovens at a frequency of 2.45 gigahertz. So it uses a microwave tube called as magnetron. Again, the term microwave oven. So it is related with microwave engineering subject. So we'll study this magnetron structure and its working here. So this is third module. Fourth module is RF transistors. You have already studied transistors, but they are all low frequency transistors. What is the difference? We have studied in transmission line something called as transit time effect. What is transit time effect? As the frequency increases, KVL and KCL are not applicable, right? So in the same way, as frequency increases, our usual BJT, FET will fail. So we have to design some other transistors. So we design something called as transistors and diodes. We design trapped transistor, then PIN diode, then HEMT transistor. These are all transistors and diodes. So they work at high frequency and they are very small, smaller than BJT and FET. So this we study in fourth module. Then fifth and sixth are again trivial models. They are all theoretical. So don't even remember what are they. They are microwave measurements and MIC transistors. So you can just refer them. They are theoretical. So we'll start with something called a Smith chart, which we already have studied in fifth semester in electromagnetics. So what is a Smith chart? It essentially, it is a conformal mapping of what? Impedance plane to gamma plane. Just to revise, what is impedance? R plus Jx. If you remember, we have started with this. This is resistance R, this is Jx. This is small, indicates what? Normalized. Why we use normalized? Because in Smith chart, we always normalize the quantities with respect to the characteristic impedance Z0 of a transmission line. Z0 is used to denote characteristic impedance of a transmission line. So if I have a resistance R, I divide it by Z0, it becomes normalized resistance. So this is plotted on the Smith chart. Okay. So resistance can be negative as well as positive. Right? Sorry, the resistance usually is positive only. So it is 0 to infinity. So it will go in this direction. Reactance can be negative as well as positive. So it can go in both the directions. So if I plot, this is the graph. So what does a Smith chart do? So if you see, this is an infinite plane, because X can go from minus infinity to plus infinity, R can go to plus infinity. So what does a Smith chart do? If you remember, it just maps all these values into a circle. And this circle is called as gamma plane. And we get various other circles. What are those various other circles? They are called as what? Constant resistance circles and constant reactance circles. So what is my constant resistance circle? This is my constant resistance circle. And what is constant reactance circle? These are my constant reactance circles, right? What are those terms? Constant reactance circles represented by red. And we have constant resistance circles represented by blue. So the combination of constant resistance and reactance circles is called as what? Smith chart. Right? So what are the important points are there in the Smith chart? We'll just revise and then we'll stop. So this is the Smith chart. So first thing is how to read the Smith chart. So as I told you, it is a combination of constant resistance and constant reactance circle. So let's start with constant resistance circle. So I have already highlighted this with black pen. So this is a constant resistance circle. So if you observe at the center, one is written. Right? And if you go like this, a circle is traced. I'll just draw that circle. So the circle with red pen is what? Constant resistance circle. And what is the value? R equal to 1. So if I go here, R equal to 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8 and 2. So this is R equal to 2 circle. Constant resistance. So you go on any point on these circles, resistance will be 2. Similarly, you go any point on this circle, resistance will be 1. Similarly, you can take bigger circle. If I take this circle on this point, resistance will be 0.4. You can take a Smith chart with you, or you can just search on Google Smith chart PDF and observe. You can zoom in and see clearly if Smith charts are not available as hardcore. Right, so this is about constant resistance circle. Then how to read reactances. So for that we require constant reactance circle. When I have drawn this outside the circle, these are not relevant because these are outside the Smith chart. How come I come to know they are outside the Smith chart? Because this represents what? Gamma plane, gamma circle. So here gamma equal to 1. So gamma, which is reflection coefficient, can never be greater than 1. This is gamma equal to 0. This is maximum gamma equal to 1. So above this, it is not relevant. So you don't use these circles. And that is why they are not drawn on the Smith chart. So if I see this circle, I go like this. This is a constant reactance circle. You see there is a value here 1. So this represents J1.0. Fine. Similarly, I'll draw any arbitrarily other circle. I go like this. Here it is 0.5. So this is J0.5 circle. Now this is positive. If I go downwards in the lower half of the circle, Smith chart, then it will be negative. I miss the trace here. It is this thing. So this is what it is intersecting at 1. So this is minus J1.0. So if I go downwards, it is negative and this is positive. Why? Because I saw here reactances can be negative as well as positive, but resistance is always positive. Right? Now how to read a value. For that I have various points here. So this is the most important point. Why? That we'll see in some time. So it is intersecting at which circle? It is exactly at the center. And there 1 is written. So resistance is what? 1. What is the reactance there? If you see this is 0.1. So this is 0.1 circle, very huge circle. So this is 0.2. This is 0.1. This is again 0.1. So this is minus 0.1. This is plus 0.1. So this should be 0. So this point is what? 1 plus J0. So this corresponds to P1. Fine. And it is called as the matched point. It is the most important point while matching. As I introduced you, we study impedance matching in this module. And the subject, it mostly hovers around impedance matching, where we have to match ZL to Z0. So when we will say ZL is matched to Z0, when we encounter P1, that is 1 plus J0. Why 1 plus J0? Because if I have a impedance of 50 ohms, ZL, load impedance of 50 ohms, I have a characteristic impedance of 50 ohms. I always normalize in Smith chart radar. So ZL by Z0 will be 50 by 50, which is 1. So it is 1 plus J0. So that same point is here. So it is matched. So what is P2? P2, if you observe, it is at the extreme left. And as you see, these values go on decreasing. So here it is 0. So for P2 we have 0. And what is the reactance? As I told, this is 0.1, this is minus 0.1, so reactance is also 0. So if you see, the impedance itself is 0. And what does a 0 impedance refer to? A short circuit. So what this indicates, this point is short circuit point. So let's come to P3. So as you go here, it was decreasing, so obviously here it is increasing. So as you come here, this is 10, 20, 50. So this should be infinity. So for P3, we have infinity. Reactance, if you see, this is 0.1, 0.2, 1, 2, 5, 10. So here also it is infinity. So here infinity. Indeterminate form, but just for the sake of telling. So it is becoming infinite. Impedance. So impedance is infinite. So impedance is infinite means what? Open circuit. So this point corresponds to what? Open circuit. These things you should remember. Right? So P1, P2, P3. Let's see P4. So P4 it is going like this. From the center you see it's going here. So this is what? 1. So P4, 1 plus what? You are in the upper part of the Smith chart. So plus. And this is the circle. So this is what? J1. J you have to add yourself on your own account. So 1 plus J1. So P4 corresponds to what? 1 plus J1. Remember, there is no unit as you are dividing ZL by Z0. So ohms ohms will get cancelled. Let's say I take any arbitrary point here. So what is this point? Let's say it is P5. So you come here along this circle. Resistance is constant. So it is what? 0.5. You go here. It is what? Again 0.5. So 0.5 plus J5 is this point. Right? Next thing which I would like to tell you about Smith chart is, this upper part is what? Always positive. So this is called as inductive part of the Smith chart, and this is always negative, and so this is what? Capacitive. Capacitive part of the Smith chart. Why? Because reactance is negative here, and Xc is what? 1 by J omega C. So means minus J by omega C. So it is negative. XL is what? Omega L. So JXL will be J omega L. So it is what? J is plus. Next. As I told you, the extreme left is short circuit. Extreme right is open circuit. Right? So these are the basics of Smith chart which you need to know. Bare minimum. So we can proceed further. So we'll stop here. Thank you.